everyone. Welcome to Talent Battle. Today in our group discussion series, we will be talking about joint family versus nuclear family. As usual, we will be having 4 points, that is the introduction, joint family, nuclear family, and then the conclusion. Now first, let's go to the introduction. Family. A family is like a bowl of fruit salad, different in taste, colors and looks, but together makes that amazing flavor which can make anyone forget their pain and take a sigh of relief. Family is the soil where our roots are held together and from where we grow as an individual, yet attached to the roots. The importance of family in India. In India, the family is the most important institution that has survived through the ages. India is a country that emphasizes family integrity, family loyalty, and family unity. The Indian family has been a dominant institution in the life of the individual and also in the life of the community. Basically, there are two types of families, joint family and nuclear family. First, let's talk about the joint families. Joint family is a type of extended family which consists of parents, their children, spouses of the children, and their offsprings all in one household. In India, the system of a joint family hails from the Vedic times and was popular even when the kings ruled this land. Nuclear family. A nuclear family is the one which consists of the husband and wife and their unmarried children. Soon after the marriage, the children leave their parental home and establish their separate household. Hence, a nuclear family is an autonomous unit free from the control of the elders. Since there is a physical distance between the parents and their married children, there is a minimum interdependence between them. Now first, let's go to the joint family. Going on since ages, India has always been known for its rich culture, various languages, and for the system of living in a joint family. A joint family does not only mean a group of people living together, but it means that these people are tied with a blood relation and choose to live in a single household for many reasons, sometimes out of will and sometimes out of compulsion. You learn the art of sharing. If you ever have lived in a joint family, you must have experienced that sharing little joys and achievements with your family members makes them so happy. Even small achievements are rejoiced by one and all. In the moments of sorrow, your family is always going to be there to support you. A kid brought up with many people is obviously more social, but he also has a habit of sharing. Living in a joint family inculcates the habit of sharing from childhood, and also it makes you focus more on we and less on me. Education beyond books. As the joint family has many elderly people, you get a very good social education by just listening to their stories and the experiences. They help you become a more mature person, and in times of needs, these are the lessons one could use for making decisions about life. All in all, living in a joint family makes one understand that there is more to education than just the school books. The feeling of togetherness. Joint family creates an emotional bond between the two generations and it helps to keep the family united in all the situations. The tradition and culture is passed on to the coming generations so they can take it forward. The proverb, "United we stand and divided we fall," goes true in the joint family system. The possibility of conflicts. As many people live together, the chances of conflicts over the values are more. The problem of living in a joint family is that even a small decision has to go through and get a green signal by every member of the family, especially from the head of the family. This, in a way, invades privacy. Nuclear family. A sense of freedom. Nuclear families have more freedom as compared to the joint family system. They do not have to worry about what the other members of the household may think. They can roam around freely and can come back at any time without being answerable to anyone. Democracy exists in a nuclear family. Development of personality. Nuclear family plays an important role in the development of the personality of individuals. Children are more close to the parents and can have more free and frank discussion about their problems with the parents, which helps for the better development of their personality. Adults in the nuclear families will learn to be independent and will take responsibility to support their family. The same will be learned by the kids and they can easily sustain when they migrate to a new area to live on their own. Less quarrels. Nuclear families face fewer quarrels when compared to the joint family. Usually, they are the small quarrels between a husband and a wife or a child and the parents. It's easy to convince everyone in the family in case of taking decisions. Problem-free unit. There is no chance of the in-laws conflict. Financial problems usually do not arise in a nuclear family. Money can be saved for future investment and to face uncertain crisis of the family. All enjoy independent life and can be engaged in any economic activities to supplement the family income. The will and the desires of the children are considered and are given proper weight. Loneliness. The feeling of loneliness is one of the most important drawbacks of the nuclear family. After the completion of the household task, the housewife becomes alone at home. At times, when the other members of the family go for a vacation, the one left behind feels very alone. Even during the time of emergency, there is hardly anyone to look up to. Children may follow the same trend and may leave their parents once they start earning. This will cause loneliness in the elderly parent. Impact on children. When both the parents are working, it will be much difficult to manage the kids. Also, children may get attracted to bad habits and bad friends easily when compared to the children that have a lot of support and guidance from parents, cousins, and uncle and aunts. Now, let's go to the conclusion. Decrease in the number of joint families. The main cause behind the deterioration of the joint families is due to the lack of opportunities and an increase in the opportunities in the towns and cities. People started migrating to the cities, leaving their roots behind in the search of jobs. Even if someone wants to bring their family to the cities with them, it is a bit difficult. Nuclear families being popularized. When compared to the joint family, nuclear families many a times feel better. They provide a peace and calm environment at home as there are very few quarrels. Every individual after coming home from work requires a peaceful atmosphere at home. As they say, small family is a happy family. But at the same time, things like depression can only be fought by living with a healthy and a happy group of people, which is not possible in the nuclear families. Irreplaceable concept of joint family. The ones who live to stay together know the values and importance of having elderly people in the house. It is important, especially during the tough times, to make good decisions in life. The children that have been brought up in the joint families would most probably opt for continuing the culture if the family is happy and has a healthy environment. Happiness matters. Being in any of these families will give you a different experience and life cycle altogether. It doesn't really matter to which family you belong to, but what matters is how you respect the people elder to you and take care of the ones younger to you, because that's what family values are. At the end of the day, a person should be happy going back home after having a long day at work. Thus, a family is that umbrella whose value is not realized until the stormy clouds loom over you. But when you look up with the hope that someone will come to your rescue, the first silent approaching steps will be that of your family members. This is family. You grow up together, learn together, agree and disagree, fight and make up, and move on in your lives. But in the end, when you need someone, you know your siblings and your family will be right there. Of course, living together is a difficult choice because in joint family, you have to put someone else's needs before yours and you have to compromise. But all these situations make you a better person. There will be feuds, compromises, sacrifices, but at the end of the day, you will have a lot more people to depend upon. Thank you.